All right, viewers, Aryan Khan's bail plea was rejected once again. Today we have accessed the bail order, and I'm going to take our viewers through what the bail order says on why Aryan Khan's bail plea is rejected. Now, WhatsApp chats, Prime Office I reveal that accused number one, Aryan Khan, is dealing in illicit drug activities on regular basis. Therefore, it cannot be said that accused one, which is Aryan Khan, is not likely to commit a similar offence while on bail. The second pointer is incriminating material in form of WhatsApp chat shows the nexus of accused number one, Aryan Khan, with suppliers and peddlers. Number three, accused acted in conspiracy with each other. There are three of them that are under arrest. Evidence on record shows that prima facie there is material to indicate that accused are part of a larger network. All right, so that's the order copy. Just breaking it down for our viewers right now. There have been five big points which tear into Aryan Khan, the reason why he has not been given bail. His bail was rejected. And out of all of them, the biggest one seems to be, and I will quote, this is what the NCB says, that there is evidence on record that shows that prima facie, there is material to indicate that accused are part of a larger network. I want to cut across right now to my colleague Vidya, who's joining us for more. Vidya, take us through this order copy, because these are scathing observations by the court to reject Aryan Khan's bail plea.
Well, the bail plea, you know, that had been filed by Aryan Khan was extremely vehemently opposed by the NCB, who said that their investigation will be hampered if this entire, you know, bail plea is allowed. So, which is one of the reasons when it was vehemently opposed on the ground of conspiracy. Remember, Section 29 of the two-hour argument that we had seen, almost 1.5 was only on Section 29 per se. And in fact, during the entire argument also, they had very clearly, the additional Solicitor General who was representing the NCB very clearly said that, you have to look at it from the point of view that the entire conspiracy was there to see to it that people get this kind of huge consignment of drugs. And that is the reason why, even if drug peddlers, because five drug peddlers have been arrested in this case, and that's one of the reasons. And in fact, the court has seemed to agree with the additional Solicitor General and has in its order very clearly said that Aryan Khan has been dealing, the WhatsApp chats that the NCB had shown to the court, that if you go through the WhatsApp chats, it's very evident that Aryan Khan had been consuming and dealing with illicit drugs for a while and on a regular basis. And even if he is granted bail, it cannot be said that he will not be doing it again. So right. Certainly, all this has really gone into the process where the court decided that the bail should not be granted to Aryan Khan and to others.
You know, Vidya, stay on with me. I'm going to pull in Nalini Sharma, my colleague, also in this conversation. Nalini, I'm going through the 4-5 pointers in the bail order, and one of them seems most scathing, because the court seems to accept that there is evidence on record that prima facie there is material to indicate that accused are part of a larger network.
Well, absolutely, Preeti. There are 3-4 main reasons on the basis of which the Sessions Court in Mumbai has denied bail to Aryan Khan. One, like you and Vidya correctly pointed out, is the fact that the court has observed that prima facie, on the basis of the arguments that were made by the NCB before the court, it seems like Aryan Khan and the others involved in the case were involved of a larger drug nexus. At the same time, the courts also said, because they've dealt with the arguments that were made by Aryan Khan's lawyers as well, they've said that even though there were no drugs that were found in possession of Aryan Khan himself, but there is sufficient evidence to show that he had the knowledge that Arbaaz Merchant was carrying 6 grams of charas, which makes it apparent that both Aryan Khan as well as Arbaaz Merchant were in conscious possessions of these drugs. That's what the court has said. And the third and the most important thing the court has said is that during the course of the investigation, Aryan Khan hadn't revealed the names of a lot of people that he was allegedly in touch with, as claimed by the NCB. So in case he's let out on bail, there is a possibility that he might alert these people, or there might be evidence that might be tampered with because the investigation is still going on. So on these grounds, the court has found no merit to grant Aryan Khan or the other two accused bail in this matter right now. It remains to be seen what happens before the Bombay High Court, because tomorrow is when the team is going to be making a mentioning, asking for the matter to be heard urgently, because that is in their benefit. But at the same time, as to whether or not the Bombay High Court will even allow for an urgent hearing of the case is something that we have to wait and watch out for. And also, of course, what kind of observations come forth on the Sessions Court order that has been passed by the Mumbai Court today.
All right, appreciate you both ladies for joining us. We're going to keep a keen eye on developments. All eyes on the Bombay High Court right now. Aryan Khan has approached the Bombay High Court. With that, I want to quickly shift focus to the other big developing story, and that is the fury of floods where two states are facing. Let's focus on one of them, Uttarakhand, and later we'll talk about Kerala. Viewers, the state of Uttarakhand in deluge. These are the latest visuals.
Deluge. Damage. Destruction. And now the hill state of Uttarakhand wears a calm as it stands on the pulse of ruins. Uprooted trees, destroyed property and tons of debris are being cleared as the rains stop. The flood fury has left several parts of the state waterlogged and businesses shut. The mayhem unleashed by the unprecedented rains still scares people.
6 से 9 बजे तक फिर पानी का लेवल स्तर इतनी तेजी से बढ़ा कि हमें अपनी दुकानें बंद करना ही मुश्किल हो गया. कुछ का सामान निकल पाया, कुछ का बिल्कुल ही नहीं निकल पाया है. सारा सामान दुकानों में ऐसे ही बंद पड़ा है, सारा सामान खराब हो गया है.
Their losses are immeasurable. Still in shock, the victims cannot even list the belongings they could not save before all of that was swept away.
जब तक हमने यहाँ आकर के लोगों को सूचना दी, कुछ सामान निकल पाया दुकानों से, कुछ नहीं निकल पाया. बहुत बड़ा नुकसान लोगों का हुआ है यहाँ.
Some of the victims are worried if they would find their villages standing when they go back.
सन 2010 में भी पानी आया था, लेकिन इतना नहीं आया था.
तब भी इतना नहीं आया.
हाँ हाँ, इस बार काफी पानी है. सामान कुछ नहीं निकाल पाए हैं. काफी करोड़ों का नुकसान हुआ दुकानदारों को.
A bit of good news. The Met Department forecasts that there will be no rains in the state in the coming days.
जो वेदर एक्टिविटी है अब 8 से 10 दिन कुछ भी अब नहीं है. तो जो लोग आना चाहते हैं उत्तराखंड है, रास्तों वगैरह को देख के पूछ के, तो वो बिल्कुल आ सकते हैं.
Life has come to a standstill for those who stay in the state of Uttarakhand. Torrential rains have wreaked havoc in the state, and most parts of the state have now submerged because of floods. The shops are shut, and those who were staying in low-lying areas, they have been evacuated. Unfortunately, more than 30 people have lost their lives. The NDRF team at the moment is continuing with the rescue work, but they believe many more have lost their lives, and the rescue work will continue for the next 2 to 3 days. This is Aishwarya Paliwal reporting from Ranpur with camera person Parminder Sharma.
All right, I'm going to shift focus right now to the state of Kerala. 3 days of extreme deluge. Finally, the Met Department has withdrawn the orange alert in 11 districts.
After 3 days of flood fury, Kerala is breathing a sigh of relief. The Met Department, which sounded an orange alert for 11 districts, has withdrawn its warning. The let-up in rains comes after several days of death and destruction, unleashed by the receding southwest monsoon. The deluge prompted at least 4 dams to release water as the storage level closed in on the danger mark. In Kottayam, several families marooned in water were evacuated to relief camps. The Shabrimala pilgrimage is suspended temporarily due to floods. Colleges in flood zone are shut till October 25th, and public service commission examination is deferred.
This is how the locals with the country-made board are out to help people, those who are in the affected areas, in the low-lying areas. And look at this, how these houses are completely submerged. And if I could say that this is not a drain, neither a river, but a motorable road, which was connecting from the remote areas, the rural, these villages, to the mainland, are now under the water, and that the depth could be more than 4 to 5 feet.
The worst of the floods may be over for now, but Kerala needs to remain cautious. The weather predictor also added that the southwest monsoon will withdraw completely by October 26th. Bureau Report, India Today.
All right, the politics of Punjab, the power play of it all. Amrinder Singh might have stepped out, Captain Amrinder Singh might have stepped out to form his own party, but where the Congress is concerned, the story remains the same. It's Congress versus Congress yet again. The players have changed. And now it's Sindhu versus the Chief Minister, Channi.
मेरी लड़ाई मुद्दियां दी है, मसलियां दी है और पंजाब पक्षी एक एजेंडे दी है। मैं हक सच दी लड़ाई लड़दा रहा, इहदे च कोई समझौता सी ही नहीं।
Abuses, bad blood and open power rivalry. The bitter war of Sardars showing no signs of abating despite an all-out truce bid by the Gandhis. The Punjab Congress split again as President Sidhu and CM Channi now openly lock horns, reaching an ugly all-time low. Sources reveal a heated exchange between Sidhu and Channi in presence of Central Observer and top Congress leaders on Sunday. Witnesses revealed Sidhu curtly raised his 13 points of governance sent to Sonia Gandhi earlier. CM Channi, in return, dared him to implement them in 2 months. A massively irked Channi then went on to cry meddling by Sidhu and threatened to quit as CM as stunned Congress leaders watched on the squabbling Sardars. Channi was much composed, speaking to media later.
Channi sahab, Sidhu sahab di naraazgi khatam hoi ja nahi?
Oh yaar, koi naraazgi nahi hai kise di, we are all chalwaan.
After losing out in the CM race, Sidhu has been vocal against inclusion of some ministers in Channi government and top officials handpicked by the CM. He had even quit as state Congress chief over his demands. And this time he is pressing the CM to book the Badal family, seeking a crackdown on their businesses. The animosity between the two had spilled out in public when Sidhu was caught on camera openly abusing the chief minister. The Gandhis had then advised Sidhu to focus on party organization. But the irrepressible Sardar is in no mood to relent. The Sidhu-Channi rivalry may spell doom for Congress in Punjab, especially when ex-CM Amrinder Singh is set to launch his own party and align with the BJP. Bureau Report, India Today.
Because if there's an election in Punjab in 5 months, there is an election in the state of Uttar Pradesh as well. And today, the Prime Minister sounded the poll bugle for the BJP by visiting Kushinagar for the slew of stops. One of them, an airport.
इन लोगों की पहचान समाजवादियों की नहीं, परिवारवादी की बन गई। अपने परिवार का भला किया, समाज का और उत्तर प्रदेश का हित भूल गए।
माननीय प्रधानमंत्री महोदय के
प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदीज ऑल आउट अटैक ऑन बीजेपीज उत्तर प्रदेश राइवल्स इन कुशीनगर। दिस व्हाइल हेलिंग Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath's fight against organized crime.
बीते साढ़े चार साल में यूपी में कानून के राज को सर्वोच्च प्राथमिकता दी गई है। 2017 से पहले जो सरकार यहां पर थी उसकी नीति थी माफिया को खुली छूट।
Minutes before that, the Prime Minister launched a mega Vikas, Buddha and Dalit push in politically crucial Purvanchal region, putting the holy city of Kushinagar on a global Buddhist circuit through उत्तर प्रदेश's थर्ड इंटरनेशनल एयरपोर्ट। On birthday of Maharishi Valmiki, revered by a large number of Dalits from the community, named after him. Many of the political influential caste members also worship the Buddha.
सुमन अर्पित करने के लिए
भगवान बुद्ध से जुड़े स्थानों को विकसित करने के लिए बेहतर कनेक्टिविटी के लिए श्रद्धालुओं की सुविधा के निर्माण पर भारत द्वारा आज विशेष ध्यान दिया जा रहा है।
चिमनदान किसी भी बौद्ध भिक्षु के जीवन
अनवेलिंग ऑफ द 260 करोड़ रुपीस इंटरनेशनल एयरपोर्ट एट बुद्धास निर्वाण साइट was attended by Buddhist monks from Sri Lanka.
This is a very symbolic and very historical location for most of the, all the Buddhists all over the world. So this will not only benefit the Buddhists from Sri Lanka, but Buddhist pilgrimage from all over the world.
The Prime Minister said, India's fast-paced vaccine drive and aviation reforms are boosting the tourism sector and air travel.
वैक्सीनेशन की भारत की तेज गति से प्रगति दुनिया के लिए एक विश्वास पैदा करेगी कि अगर टूरिस्ट के रूप में भारत जाना है किसी कामकाज से भारत जाना है तो भारत व्यापक रूप से वैक्सीनेटेड है। भगवान बुद्ध से जुड़े स्थानों को विकसित करने के लिए बेहतर कनेक्टिविटी के लिए श्रद्धालुओं की सुविधा के निर्माण पर भारत द्वारा आज विशेष ध्यान दिया जा रहा है। देश का एविएशन सेक्टर प्रोफेशनली चले, सुविधा और सुरक्षा को प्राथमिकता मिले, इसके लिए हाल में एयर इंडिया से जुड़ा बड़ा कदम देश ने उठाया है।
Prime Minister also visited the Mahaparinirvana temple in the city, which has the famous Buddha statue in a reclining position. And there he offered prayers. A government medical college was among the 11 development projects kicked off by the Prime Minister in Kushinagar. A poll bugle in the state that holds key to India's political future. Follow me, Saha, in Kushinagar. Bureau Report, India Today.
Welcome back. You're watching our Fact Check segment where we bust certain myths masquerading to be facts on social media platforms and WhatsApp groups. Now, there is a claim which is floating about suggesting that idol desecration clip which has gone viral as anti-Hindu violence in Bangladesh. The fact check on that, this is a very old video of over 2 years, not part of the current ongoing violence in Bangladesh. With that quick fact check, time for us to go into a quick break, but do stay with me. On the other side is To The Point.